So you may know about the pose brush, which you can use in sculpt mode to pose a character which is not meant for rigging, just a sculpt. And recently they implemented a way to use face heads to your advantage there, which makes the tool really much better. Let me show you what I mean. So I am in object mode here. I will go to edit mode and enable X-ray view and use the lasso select here, and I'll just select the entire arm. So this is selected all the way through. In sculpt mode, I can then make a face set from the edit mode selection. So we have this. And I can do that again. Deselect X-ray view, and this time I'll select everything up to the elbow. And then in sculpt mode, again, face set from edit mode selection. So now I have these two face sets, one for the upper arm and one for the lower arm. So what I can do now is here with the pose brush, if I go to the tool panel here, normally it is set to geometry to rotate based on the topology, but we can set it now to face sets, and then you can see it picks the face set. So I can move it like this or move it like this. And that's okay, but it gets better because now we can use the cloth sim to do the same thing. And the advantage of that is that when you move this, you can see that it is actually doing some cloth simulation instead of just rotating the geometry. Let me show you here. So you see, you get these nice cloth folds. Let me show you the difference. So if I just use geometry, then it just bends like this. So you don't get any folds here, as opposed to with cloth sim. It goes a little bit slower, but you get this, these beautiful folds. And that's difficult to sculpt, so you get that for free. But another thing that you can do, you have more than just rotate and twist here. You also have scale and squash and stretch. And what we can do here with squash and stretch is we can squash it, and then you get all these really cool folds. Of course, that makes the arm a little bit shorter. So what I recommend is that you do this with geometry first to stretch it out a little bit. And then go back to cloth sim, and then you can squash it back to the original length. But then you get all these cool folds. Of course, you get a little bit of intersecting stuff here. Easy to solve with some smooth brush. So that's pretty cool. Get these nice folds here and here, and all along the lower arm. When I unhide the rest, also here, you can see that there's now some intersecting, but if I just press Alt Q and select that mesh, and then use the grab brush, I can move that back.